hip-hop.
Hey, let's move! Hip-hop, 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 hip. It's bigger than
hip-hop. Yeah,
but no.
Hip-hop is something you live.
So, echte hip-hop in je smooth. Echte hip-hop in je smooth.
Come on.
Yeah. We got a lot of inspiration out of anime and shit.
Well, hell yeah. Huh. A bunch of inspiration out of anime. I mean, the genin, the title itself, comes from an anime series. And the chunin is just a bunch of short stories that I got inspiration from all kinds of anime episodes, you know, movies, episodes, whatever. Animated and inspired me, I wrote about it and made a song.
Yeah, you basically just twist the plot of all kinds of anime series around and...
Exactly, like I put myself in the shoes of the character I'm talking about that was in that anime. And like I'm seeing everything through his eyes, basically. Yeah, that's how I like to rap.
Well, with a twist, though.
With a little twist, you know, obnoxious twist. We wouldn't be called obnoxious otherwise.
I'm so polio-subnoxious, kinda make Bill's above look like an angry goth chick. What kind of broth is this? Primordial soup, dude, ain't it marvelous? Kinda make you wanna bark to it like a pack of hellhounds heralding apocalypse.
The kinda first thing coming up right now is just the first real obnoxious album.
Yeah.
Right now it's not... We called it D.O., but that's just the working title.
Yeah, we didn't really have a final name.
But it's all done except for one more verse, a dude to rap, and
yeah, M-Rock.
It's all rap, it's like 16 tracks.
Yep.
And, well, the main thought behind that album is just raw, hardcore, hip-hop shit with a little experimental tip to it.
Yeah, exactly.
That's it.
Bring, like, some fresh air back to rap, man.
I need her, she lethal like Femme Nikita. Queen of heartbreak is known as Love's Reaper. Your best use your hand cause it's much cheaper. She now ran into Frankie, the heart stealer. King of hearts, I'll be the dealer. She's asleep, well, I'll be her pillar. Got a same boy in bed, you's a killer. Porn wars mean you're her top biller. I step in, my cap bill tilt to the ceiling. Whatever drink I'm sipping, she killing, no spilling. Set my heart to her mind, and likewise from her to me. In due time, sublime, combo pop like landmines.
Like I always say to him, what's the concept? Because if he don't tell me what the concept is, I'm just going to sit there and start writing something. So I always say to him, tell me a concept, and then I'm going to go in and just stick to that concept. And one verse is easy to write, so we just get that out the way. He writes his.
It's not always one first, but that's basically how it
goes. Well, for the group albums.
We just think up a concept, and after that, he finishes his first, usually. And then I just go off that shit, because, well, we made up a concept I am able to write to, and he's always quick enough with that shit.
Don't have time to waste.
Kinda make you wanna stomp your feet to this like I do all day with my click up in the attic. Making some noise till my mom shouts, get out, you boys. I had enough of this, man. You're making my fucking brain twitch. I'm just saying some shit. I'm Pleozoic, the microbe from 5 million years ago. And I go off the brain cause I had some shit remembered, but I forgot it the instant I got on this machine. So whatever, I'll be spitting that shit clever all day. Well, mostly cause lately, since January, I've been in the studio stuck making beats for dude and so and so and so and him and her. And I'll be just doing this shit absurdly flurry, cold like flurries or warm like magma. I spit this shit from the top of my head like whatever. I don't give a flying fuck or sever my head if you wanna. I'm just saying some shit from the top of my head, cause you know I'm gonna and will anytime you put me on this mobile mic device, right?
Yeah, I know. Completely different background.
Yeah, but we think that is a bit of what the flavor geeft.
Yeah, it matches well. Cause our voices are completely different too. He's very... His voice is like well in your face. Like he's got this commanding tone in his voice. So when he speaks, you just listen.
I'm just trying to swallow the mic.
Yeah, and me, I'm usually...
He's laid back. And
I'm very laid back individual.
Going with the swagger.
Yeah, swagging.
Nee, maar dat is het mooie ervan, zeg maar. We zijn eigenlijk totaal tegenpolen in wat we doen, zeg maar. En juist daardoor vormt het een mooi, divers geheel, zeg maar. Dat is denk ik ook wel de kracht van onze groepalbums.
Man, I'll be kicking this shit all day, any day. At least one hour if I'm not at school or at work. That's all I do, do it absurd, do it again and again. I know the routine, been doing this for 11 years since, what was it, 1997? Ever since Wu-Tang, I was up into heaven. That's why RZA is my main instructor and master. Well, somehow, some way, man, I just paved the way for the people that follow in my wake on the beats that I make, and I make them like, hey.
Even on my solo albums, I'm always saying to him, can you get on this song, get on this song, get on this song, because I like rapping with the dude, yo. Like, the verses he writes every time on my solo albums, he writes a verse, yeah, and then I'll hear that verse, and I start hating on him, because the shit is so fresh, it sounds so good, and then I go back, and I'm like, I need to rewrite this verse, because you're making me look bad on my own album.
Oh, you narcissistic bastard. Luca, Luca, the mojo master. Don't need sexy jutsu, I go off charisma. Reel in, hook, line, and sinker. Chang, Chang, she getting played over here. Shift the Shaguar into the fifth gear. Damn it.
I mean, he made the Genin in 2 weeks.
Yeah, seriously.
I just made the beats in a week, and next week he wrote all the lyrics and da-da.
That's usually the pace, though, ain't it?
Yeah.
Two, three weeks maximum. And the album's done.
Obnoxious Timira. Baga. Ja, zeg maar, we gaan vanaf het startpunt dat we elk album eigenlijk een totaal andere invalshoek, muzikaal een totaal andere vibe, textueel een andere insteek, andere vorm van het brengen van de teksten willen hebben eigenlijk. Zeg maar, de Obnoxious, dat is gewoon straight up hip-hop shit, spur of the moment dingen, just write and finish that track.
Royal
Komodo Mojo mode on killer croc. Slide on my belly, I forgot how to walk. Greenery, grocery, martini on the rocks. Room smells like sex and dirty socks. I'm ghostly, ghastly, Urutsuki Doji cast me. Legend of the Alpha Fiend and hit him with a mojo beam. Run the modus of Perundi, programmed to be the bummy sonic equivalent of El Bundy. Yeah, honey, I know I'm yummy.
Man-made man, that's what it's called. Because we're
man-made man.
Yeah, focusing on how men made men to do and look and act how the hell they want them to.
Basically,
man wants to be God.
Ja, hoe de geestestaat van de mens eigenlijk beïnvloed wordt en gemaakt is door de mens. Eigenlijk alles wat we nou denken, doen, onze concepten, ideeën, het is alleen gebaseerd op wat in de mensen al omgaat voor honderden jaren.
Damage here to dig deep in the muff till she tell me enough is enough. What? So wet that it slid in the butt. Slut. She love when Frankie at the cut. Cause my mojo like Austin Powers pops. Said enough. Actions gets the results. Valentino, Domo, Casanova gotta catch up to young Franco. Deep rap lust, marvelous like Stan Lee sketched us. Dust. Product when your heart's crushed by the mojo. She bounced on my dick like pogo. Then I bounced, skedaddled and left her with a dildo and the rose placed on her pillow. Now she weep like Willow.
Yes, dat is Soul Pleozoic, dat is mijn solo album. Waarin ik in de huid kruip van een 5 miljoen jaar oude amoebe, microbeestje. En vanuit die geestestaat verken ik zeg maar het hedendaagse leven. Niet heel strikt het hele album door, maar het was zeg maar het uitgangspunt voor het maken dat ik zeg maar I'm Mr. Pleozoic. Ik ben gewoon die microbe en ik loop hier tussen de mensheid rond en ik rap in mijn vrije tijd. En op die wijze kijk ik een beetje vanuit zeg maar een kind of alienated ogen naar de hele wereld om me heen.
That album is stupid fresh.
Once upon a time somewhere over the rainbow, the old got paid that waiting gold. Listen to my story, this is the way it was. It all happened in a place called the Land of Oz. The wicked witch of the east was enriching plutonium now. Word on the yellow brick streets buzzing out loud. And the west of the west stockpiling tactical nukes. All up in the streets recruiting emerald troops. Now the scarecrow, this homie we knew from way back. Sway with the hay and actively laid back. He was scheming on overthrowing both the wizard and the witch. Seizing the emerald throne and all of the rest.
Sex Drugs is more of a
straight up hip-hop record.
Yeah, it's basically hip-hop. It's got a lot of hip-hop elements in it, like old school. It sounds quite old school, actually. But with a new school twist.
Yeah, true. Het uitgangspunt voor de sound was gewoon soulvolle, funky shit.
Yeah.
Straight up, rechtstreeks gejackte looks. En
jazzy riffs in there.
Gewoon rauwe hip-hop met een funky inslag. Dat is het, basically.
Yeah, and at the end of the album, get sucked through a wormhole and end up on the planet Vagina, where I start Sex, Drugs, Volume 2, once I get to it.
Bob Bump is mijn alter ego. En dat wordt een puur, ja, niet puur instrumentaal, maar het enige wat ik erop doe is de beats maken, zeg maar. Alle beats zijn gewoon live gemaakt, free will. Ik heb gewoon die synthesizers daar staan en kloot wat aan. En wat daaruit komt, dat worden de beats, zeg maar, alle beats zijn al klaar. Ik moet hier en daar nog een klein detailtje adden en zeg maar 3, 4 of 5 feature MC's erop. En dan is die shit ook helemaal klaar.
Foreplay, something I like to practice. Practice make perfect, perfect make artist. Artists make cash regardless. Love it, chick love it. When the clit I touch it, rub it. Public display of fucking. That's PDF, I thought it was PDA. Well I MIB, I flash it, you didn't see me. Honey say I make her feel oh so horny. She adores me, even if I'm poor she's calling. Keeping her wet like Niagara Falls or something. I know she whooped, so I'm acting mad bougie. Like that chick told Rick, she swat fucker in the pussy. It's good.
Tuning, that's the second level of Ninja.
Yeah, the follow up to the Genin.
Yeah, follow up to the Genin, and it's so much sicker.
yeah, because on the Genin, he was just fucking around.
Yeah, I was just fucking around, you know, that's the first album.
But on a Tuning, every track is gonna be a straight, like, story.
It's strict to this. Yeah. I'm not writing anything down if it's not on topic, and everything is a story in itself. So mm-hmm. Everything's a short story, start to end of the everything I'm saying, first word to the last damn word.
We hebben het laatst, sinds januari, we made like, I guess 120, 130 tracks.
Yeah, well, yeah, we get down, man. I don't count, I just...
That's not counting the instrumentals and shit.
That one's Rockstar Reggae, the second reggae album, and that one is... It's more of a reggae album mixed with the sex, drugs, and hip-hop vibe. It's, yeah, it's nice. It's really cool. You'll like that. It's quite catchy. The beats are, how do you describe the beats you made?
Less reggae, more rock.
Yeah, exactly. We're trying to make like, well, you could be a rock star in any type of music, man. It's how you carry yourself. Yeah, but we're making rock
we're
star
We're
going to
involve like more live musicians on this
one. Oh, of course, yeah.
Because on the first reggae album, Man Made Man,
it was
like,
strictly more reggae-ish.
Yeah. Plus we didn't have that much featurings. Like, of people, you know, play guitar, drums or shit. Just a few parts in which somebody played a riff for us, but the rockstar reggae thing is gonna be way more instrumental.
Yeah, a lot more musical.
She yap in my ear, something about something. I'm not trying to hear that shit, I'm like, yeah, that's so lovely. Now could you get me my beer, cause I'm all out of money. She's in the bag and all is fair in love and war. So I hijacked that glass and left her standing at the bar. My mojo was straight up the charts on the scale of ridiculous. But mix the big cheese, he really don't give a shit. He's on some bummy, frivolous, loose lip, missile, drip, spistle, spit it. Isn't it? Well, exactly so, bro, cause of my mojo.
Another Bob Bump one. Yeah. Called it Hidden Quest.
I like that. Hidden Quest.
Dat wordt gewoon een plaat met meer atmosferische shit erop. Heel erg Japans geïnspireerd. Ik weet niet of je Kitaro kent. Een Japans artiest die zeg maar heel etherische, zweverige, atmosferische dingen maakt. Hij heeft denk ik een stuk of 40, 50 platen op zijn naam staan. Hij is ook al jarenlang bezig. Maar dat is zeg maar een van de grote invloeden, zeg maar, op die plaat.
It's gushy, but I keep on teasing. Lay back, let the boy taste the seasoning of healing. Close eyes, wet dreaming. That's how this shit feeling. Then I hand drum a pussy. Da 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 da. Drum solo, excuse me. Drum roll on her booty.
En dan komt als zeg maar afsluiten van deze hele serie van met creativiteit en zo de mixtape op waarop we gewoon met meerdere artiesten gewoon it's gonna be called the Hyperbolic Tape Chamber. Zeg maar, het wordt een soort van terugblik op alles wat we gedaan hebben.
Now the scarecrow thought of different methods to conquer as mass destruction just wasn't his style. Picked up his phone, sent word to the obnoxious, asked us to take both of his opponents out. We was like, yeah, don't you worry, homie, this'll be over with before you can say shit. I think I saw a shinobi. If it's 30 of your best man that can fight like Obi, and each of us will carry a team like Kobe. Show, but hey, first pay us half the gold. You know we the old, we know the way the paper fall as we said, so we did train the team to level Genin. Gave Excalibur plans, strapped our gear and got to jamming. Now you know how it go when the O get together. We brought the scarecrow, two heads on silver platters.
Willen ze ook zo snel mogelijk de deur uit hebben, zodat we geen tijd hebben om zeg maar te gaan twijfelen aan wat we gemaakt hebben. Want ja, dat heb ik in het verleden wel gedaan. Dan maak ik iets en dan ligt het daar een jaar en dan luister je terug en dan denk je van ja, dat was echt cool en ik heb er veel, zeg maar, veel van geleerd, beatwise, flowwise, textwise. Maar het is niet meer waar ik nou mee down ben. En dan is eigenlijk al die moeite een beetje voor niks geweest, want dan ligt je hart er niet meer bij en dan ja, kan je het beter weggooien. Dus daarom dat we elke maand gewoon, zodra die shit af is, gaat het eruit, kunnen we weer verder.